We were camped on the bend at the head of the Cimarron, when along come a stranger, and he stopped to argue some. Well, he looked so very foolish, we began to look around. We thought he was a greenhorn just escaped from town. He said he'd lost his job upon the Santa Fe and was going across the prairie to strike the 70. He didn't say how come it, some trouble with the boss, and ask if he could borrow a fat saddle horse. This tickled all the boys to death, they laughed right up their sleeve. Oh, we will lend you a fine horse, as fresh, as fat as you please. Then Shorty grabbed the lariat and he roped the zebra dun, and he gave him to the stranger and waited for the fun. Now old Dunny was an outlaw, he had grown so very wild. Well, he could paw the moon down, boys, he could jump a mile. Old Dunny stood right still as if he didn't know, until he was saddled and ready for to go. When the stranger hit the saddle, well, old Dunny quit the earth. He's traveled right straight upwards for all that he was worth. A bucking and a squealing and a having walleyed fits, his hind feet perpendicular, his front feet in the bits. We could see the tops of the mountains under Dunny's every jump. The stranger, he was growed there just like the camel's hump. The stranger sat upon him and he curled his black mustache just like a summer boarder who was waiting for his hash. Well, he thumped him in the shoulders and he spurred him when he whirled. He hollered to the punchers, I'm the wolf of the world. And when he had dismounted once more upon the ground, we knew he was a thoroughbred and not a gent from town. Now the boss, who was a-standing round a-watching of the show, he walked up to the stranger and he said he needn't go. If you can handle a lariat like you rode the zebra dun, you're the man that I've been looking for since the year of one. Well, there's one thing and a sure thing I've learned since I've been born, that every educated feller ain't a plum greenhorn.